is the air I breathe. This is the air I breathe. Your holy presence, living in me. This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me. And I this is the air I breathe. This is the air I breathe. How many of you are hungry for God?
Are you hungry for him? More of him. Who wants the floodgates to open up?
Thank you. Just reach. Yes, Lord, we believe you, God. We believe you, God. We believe you, God. We believe you, God. Oh, dear Jesus, God, give them when they get on that fourth plane tomorrow, God, and they go to Atlanta and transfer for that long flight back to Honolulu. Lord, you just meet with that plane as it soars.
We know that, God, it's your hand is upon it. In a very special way, dear God. And we thank you for it. And we thank you for it. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. This is your daughter. This is your child. And we want to build a hedge around her family, her life, dear God. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Satan cannot penetrate. God sent it. Them down and we lift up the cross. We plead the blood of Jesus. We plead the blood that was shed at Calvary.
Thank you, Father God, that you
that you set a path for her, Lord God. Father, a clear path, Lord God. Father, that she can follow, Lord God. That you've laid it out, Lord God, just like the yellow brick road, Father God, that she'll see it clearly, Lord God. Father, there'll be no confusion, Lord God, when she makes decisions, Father. God, it'll be clear, God, in Jesus' name, Father. Father God, thank you for giving her authority, God. Giving her authority over the enemy, Lord God. She rebukes the enemy. He flees, Lord God, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father, for setting her, God, in high places, Father God. Father God, for giving her a place, Lord God, where she can speak your word, God. She can speak your word clearly, Father God. Father God, thank you for anointing her mind, Lord God, her mouth, Father God. Her steps, Father, are ordered of you, Lord God. Thank you, Father, for giving her messages, God. Father, that she can begin to write them on paper, Lord God. Father, that she'll speak for you, Lord God, that God, the call that is upon her life, Lord God, is strong, Father. Father God, we just rebuke the enemy, God, that has come to destroy, Father, in Jesus' name, Father. We just pray a hedge of protection around her, Lord God. And we cover her with your blood, God. Just one drop of your blood, God, is all it takes. Just one drop, God. You did it all on Calvary, God. Just one drop, God. We just bind up every work of the enemy, Lord God. In Jesus' name, Father. God, thank you for calling her, Lord God. Thank you, Father, for anointing her, Father. In Jesus' name, God. Thank you for helping her to walk in authority, Father. And thank you, God, for calling her back home, God. In Jesus' name, God, we just bring a party, God, and we thank you for calling her back home, Father. In Jesus' name.
We agree together. Amen. Deal with headquarters. Pay for her furniture to come back.
Yes.
The automobiles, God. Lord, we pray for Darwin, God. I pray, God, this man, God, has such anointing on his life. Oh, God. God, I pray that he'll find more joy and peace and comfort working for you than Swapolis, God. Oh, dear Jesus, establish him in a church where that he can use his giftings and callings, and God, he can minister for you. He can use his administrative ability, his teaching ability. He can be an influence on so many people, God. Oh, Lord, use him. Give him more joy and contentment than he's ever had in this life. Fill the void, God. Let his cup run over, God, because he's ministering to you. He's bowing at your feet, God. Always at your feet, doing what you want him to do. And God,
No.
Are you ready for your picture?
I think she's going to get a little snapshot.
Hey, River, come on, honey.
I got you on video. Look, you're on my camera. There she is. Look, you're on my camera. There's Grandma and Grandpa waiting.
Gonna get a picture of your underwear.
Say hi.
Hi.
Yeah.
Guess who's rushing and packing?
Oh, yes.
Hi. Say hello.
Look, she's probably
hi.
Yes, we're gonna have to sit on her.
Where's River at? Where's her brother?
River disappeared.
Yeah. Oh.
He's under something.
Good day.
Oh, goodness. Where's he at? Is he hiding?
Where's
River? Is he hiding?
He's under the table.
He lives.
River. Riverman.
He's hiding somewhere.
Where is River? I bet he's in the closet.
Hey, River, where's he at?
River. River.
Oh, gosh.
Where are
I heard
you
him.
No. Come on, Dakota.
No.
Okay.
I'm going to be latched. I need latched. What do you want to get a picture? Yeah. I do, but I want to be latched.
They're all packed. They're all packed, ready to go? Mm-hmm. I think she looks like a double.
Stop it!
Now, that's sitting like a proper lady.
Stop it!
Oh, she looks beautiful. Look at her hair now.
Stop it!
Uncle Jeff!
Okay, we got River.
Oh, no.
Oh my goodness. I got a nice memorial video of your rush.
Come on.
Rush.
Here. I
want
to
be last.
You
are
last.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Say hi to my camera. Hey, do you want to go sit with your grandpa, with your Mimi and Papa?
Yeah. I want to sit with you.
You do? Okay.
I just want to change. I don't want to wear this.
Hey, do you want to get a video with your Mimi and your Papa?
No.
Okay.
I want to go with you.
Say that like you mean it.
Okay, 1, 2, 3. Can you smile? Smile for my camera.
You think I'll be crying in the morning?
1, 2. Say hi, camera.
Hi.
You're not gonna take a picture
with Mommy and Mimi, Sissy?
No. Uh-oh, you alright?
Uh-oh. I turned the light on just so you can see in the video.
Uh-oh.
There he is. You bought a picture of his...
Yeah, I did. Now he wants pictures on the bed.
No. Oh, no.
That's my bed.
No, it's not. It's your bed.
I got him playing behind the pillow in the bed, so just in case. Will he cooperate if I hold him or not? What if he walks outside on the sidewalk?
Well, we gotta get in the car anyway.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. Are we on?
Good morning. You're on.
All right. Picture bulletins, and let's stay together and we'll read Psalm 16, 7 through 11.
Everyone ready? I will bless the Lord who hath given me counsel. My reins also instruct me in the night seasons. I have set the Lord always before me, because he is at my right hand. I shall not be moved. Therefore my heart is glad, and my glory rejoices. My flesh also shall rest in hope. For thou wilt not leave my soul in hell, neither wilt thou suffer thine Holy One to see corruption. Thou wilt show me the path of life. In thy presence is fullness of joy. At thy right hand are pleasures forevermore.
And that's the truth.
Isn't that wonderful?
Amen.
In thy presence is fullness of joy. At thy right hand there are pleasures forevermore. Isn't that great? Amen. Thank God for that. Do we have any special requests this morning?
Brother Raymond called last night, and his son-in-law in Tennessee is critical, and he's out immediately. We're down there. So it's very cold for him to travel. He was going alone. But I'm sure he made it, or he would have called.
So, pray for him. Okay, let's pray for Norma. She had a little accident out here Thursday night, and they got that walk out there purposely to trip you.
Yeah, a little bit tired if I watch it.
It's very unsafe. So she's doing good. We're just happy for that. Any other requests this morning?
I don't have a request. I have a praise report.
Okay.
My dad, I asked for prayer Thursday night because they found a mass on his thyroid.
Mm-hmm.
When they did the second test, after I had prayer from Dressing for Destiny and from here, they couldn't find anything.
Couldn't find anything?
Praise the Lord.
Was it a mass?
A mass.
Around his thyroid?
On his thyroid.
Well, thank God. Well, we'll take all we can get of those, won't we?
Yeah.
Those are blessings of the Lord. Okay. Let's remember our nation. Our president and those that are in authority, and let's especially remember our upcoming election of our president, and we need to let the Lord will get the right man in there, a woman. I guess I better be careful. We trust the Lord to get the right person in there. Okay. Any requests up here?
No.
No?
Okay. Just pray that God shows us the path of life.
Sister Lola, lead us in prayer.
Dear Heavenly Father, we just come before you, Father, with praise and thanksgiving for our lives and all the lives around us, Father, that you put each of us in a bond of family, Father, that is so great. And you invest in us for a purpose, Father, in this church and watching us go forward. Even though the devil has attacked our preacher, and now he's better, Father, and Satan, we laugh at you in the name of Jesus. We laugh. You will not. The gates of hell shall not prevail against us, that we are going forth in victory, Father, that you are victorious, Father, that you are the God that created us, and you're so awesome, Father. We love you so much, and we praise you. And we just offer up this sacrifice of praise that we're doing. It's no sacrifice, Father, because you're worthy, Father. You're worthy of all our service. We lift it up in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Okay. Cindy, where is Nathan today?
Megan is in Indianapolis with her sister Jamie and sister Amanda that just flew in last night from Nigeria.
What you?
Amanda did.
Shake hands, be friendly for just a second or two here.
So we have, this is your mother.
It's Jenny.
The old lady.
It's Sherry.
Where's my phone?
Thank you. Thank you. obeying the Lord. Yes. What a wonderful spirit. What a thing awesome God. Lord, we just lift up this precious couple to you, God. Lord, we pray, God. We pray, Lord, that you will use them more than they've ever been used. In the name of Jesus, you agree, church? More than they've ever been. Oh, God, open doors. God, fulfill once and for all and establish, God, their goings and comings. And God, may they be anointed with you to do your work. We pray in the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
This church loves you, Jesus.
Yes.
They love you.
Yes,
we do. Love you. Hallelujah. God's on the
door. Yes.
This little girl and her family, husband, and children leave in the morning for Lexington at 6 a.m.
And who's
going to
get up and take them?
At least trying, not giving up. Wouldn't it be easy to give up every now and then? I'm getting nowhere. No one appreciates me. You know, that's what the disciples were. They sat around the table with Jesus and tell us, who's going to be the greatest in the kingdom? Who's going to be the greatest? When he ascended to heaven, they said, will your kingdom be done? Lord, let them believe in you and the cross, the death, burial, and resurrection of our Savior. And we love you so much. Fulfill your tithes. Fulfill your commission to this precious couple, God. And Lord, keep your hand up on them. God, let nothing that is not according to your will come to pass, God. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray.
Thank you.
You both believe in Jesus that he died on the cross. In your precious name, hallelujah.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Jesus.
Bless
you,
Jesus.
And love you too.
We need to get into the holies of holies. And we can do that. So this message will simply point out some scriptural reasons for speaking in tongues. We're going to examine the scriptural basis for why we believe this doctrine is very significant for believers from the time of the initial experience in the upper room at Pentecost right up to today. Jesus said his followers would speak in tongues. That's from the mouth of Jesus. In Mark 16:17-8. And these signs shall follow them that believe. In my name shall they cast out devils. They shall speak with new tongues. Listen to me, church.
Yeah.
They shall speak with new tongues. A tongue that they had never spoken before. They never heard of it. But he began to speak to them. They shall take up serpents, and if they break any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. They shall lay hands on the sick, and they shall recover.
Amen.
Now, it was Jesus himself who said that believers would speak in tongues. It's a gift from God. Oh, in your inner sanctum, in your closet, and wherever you are, communicate with you, shut out everything and receive a blessing from the Lord.
Amen.
It's wonderful to be able to speak and I can have a prayer language. I can go into my closet, or I can begin to speak in that, but I'm going to speak anytime. Anytime I'm driving down the highway, I'll just begin, oh, what's your name? Oh, my gosh, you know, my God. Holy, my gosh, I'm coming out. Holiness. 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 I thank you for that prayer language.
Yeah.
I don't know what I'm saying. And he said, man, I don't understand that, but you're communicating to the Father. You are blessed, and the Father is blessed, and you can talk to Him in a language that you don't understand.
Amen.
Isn't that wonderful?
Yeah.
And there's the holies of death. Goodness, what a wonderful blessing. So Jesus, who said that believers would speak in tongues, we see from the above scriptural passage that the experience was instituted by Jesus. Prayer in tongues is a direct prayer to God. It's a prayer to God. Oh, we don't need a priest anymore.
Yeah.
In the old covenant, everybody couldn't go into the presence. They couldn't go into that inner sanctum where the presence of the Lord was. The Ark of the Covenant was there. And the presence of the Lord was on top of that ark. Only the high priest could go in and hear what the Lord wants to hear. Wasn't that awful? People had to carry the load of that people in and make a sacrifice for the sins of the people. And that was all they could do then. And then they go right back out and do the same way they were before. But thank God when Jesus came back, he spoke to his disciples and he said, receive ye the Holy Spirit. Receive ye the Holy Spirit. Why? They had not been regenerated yet. They had followed Jesus for 3.5 years, but Jesus had not gone to the cross yet, so they needed to be regenerated. So he said, receive ye the Holy Spirit. That was conversion. That wasn't receiving the baptism, because later on, he said, go back to Jerusalem and pray for you, being due to the power from on high. And on the day of Pentecost, it came down and it baptized 120 people at the same time.
Amen.
All of you ever received the baptism of the Holy Spirit, my people are missing out on a blessing. Seek what God has for you. And on the day of Pentecost, they were praying. That 120, the mother of Jesus, all the disciples. And they came out then, and they began to worship the Lord, and the Spirit came down like tongues of fire and fell upon them. 3,000 people were saved instantly. They were gathered there from every nation. That was a day of Pentecost. That was the day when they came together and offered up a sacrifice. And 3,000 people received Jesus, received the baptism. Now we need to enter into this. We pray that people's salvation, and that's the most wonderful blessing. We can't deny that, but there's more for you. Now after you receive the baptism, don't stop there, because that's just the initial evidence. He's equipped you to do great things for Him. Instead, when He told them, speak with your tongues, you shall lay hands on the sick, and they shall recover. And we need to see that in our midst.
Right.
And I thank God that He's our healer.
Amen.
Kevin, He's our healer. I don't put the doctors down. You should go and be examined, make sure that you have a healer. Nothing wrong with that. Some people don't believe in that, and that's okay. I know a couple of people that live like that, and they die. And we said, hey, I'm going to go to a doctor. And they call his ear. Oh, cancer. But the one thing was brain. And he was good with blankets. And he would not go to the entire doctor. His father said, I can't move to the doctor. He said, I don't want you to do anything. He said, hold your phone. And he wants you to give me up. Now, I believe we should do all that we can. God is the healer. He's the healer. And as we as Christians need to enter in to all that God has for us, let's go before the throne. He's brought me through two of them now.
Hallelujah.
to serve them will be the last.